Well, Tim Bright of the United States, as we mentioned before, is a pole vaulter turned decathlete. And even though he is well down in the competition and not up there with Thompson and Hinkson, Tim Bright was getting set here for his final attempt at 17 feet 8 and 1 half inches. He had missed on his first two attempts, so his second effort was a very good one. And with all eyes fixed upon him, he went up and over a new Olympic record, which he had already established at a lower height. He increases that record to 17 feet 8 and 1 half inches. And just to show you how many points a vault like that will earn you in decathlon competition, Tim Bright picked up 1,143 points at that height, and he's still going. They're going to move the bar up, and Bright will try to pick up even more. So Tim Bright of the United States, 17.8 and a half, that is 1 foot 4 inches better than anybody else. Daley Thompson went out at 16.4 and three quarters. As you take another look at Tim Bright, Marty.
Well, for Tim, this is kind of a routine jump, except that it's coming in the middle of a decathlon when he'd be a lot tired. He's not real exuberant when he gets out of the pit, because even though the crowd is going wild, he knows that he's been up there higher before, and he probably jumped this high in practice many times before. But as you said, he's able to get an enormous amount of points in the pole vault, because when they made up those tables, the fiberglass vaulting pole really wasn't even thought of, and therefore it's very easy for a good pole vaulter to come in and score a lot of points.
He was in 11th place after seven events. Meanwhile, Jürgen Hinkson is already underway in the javelin. You can see he had a knee problem last night. He obviously has an elbow problem here tonight. Hinkson's throw, his first throw was 170 feet, 1 inch. And then his second effort was 198 feet, 3 inches. This throw just taking place moments ago. A better throw, but he has paid the price for it, and he is in a lot of trouble right now, because Daley Thompson, with a tremendous effort in the pole vault, has increased his lead. And the real drama right now is, will Daley Thompson break the world record? Thompson, the leader, and he has yet to throw the javelin. Hinkson has thrown twice. So that's the update from here, and right now, let's go to Jack Whitaker.
All right, Al Michaels, thanks very much. We're coming up here to Michelle Mitchell, who was in third place after six rounds. Behind the two Chinese women who are actually making these preliminaries their own private party. Michelle Mitchell.
Back 1.5 somersaults with 2.5 twist. It's normally a good dive for Michelle, but she would have to do it spectacularly in order to come close to the Chinese girls at this point.
Moment, isn't it?
Certainly is, especially when you're that high above the water, thinking about heading towards it. It is a good dive, although she needed more arm swing on the beginning in order to make the dive. Let's watch it again. She swings her arms and needs to go a little further through with that arm swing. Comes out, lines it up a little bit short of vertical. The judges are right. The crowd didn't really like it, though.
They don't like those 5.5s. 53.76, that will keep her in third place.
405 feet, inward 2.5 somersaults, height 2.8.
So here are the standings after the seventh round. We have one more dive. We'll be back in just a moment.
The moment on Kodacolor VR400, one of Kodak's fastest color print films ever.
Like a brilliant shooting star, reaching for the sky, how you'll shine as time goes by.
Kodak, official film of the U.S. track and field team.
It's your first taste of the day, starting fresh, starting pure. It's your first taste of the day, so you make sure.
always make sure our first taste of the day is the best it can be, with 100% pure Minute Maid orange juice.
The first taste of the day.
Have you tried the unexpected granola bar?
This is a granola bar?
Quaker Chewy granola bars. Unexpected.
It isn't hard and crumbly.
Unexpectedly moist.
Unexpected.
Unexpectedly moist and chewy.
Minus chocolate chips.
Delicious Quaker Chewy granola bars. If you've never been excited about a granola bar before, you haven't tried the unexpected granola bar.
Unexpected.
Quaker Chewy granola bars. Look for Quaker Chewy in individual bars, too.
At Arco, Atlantic Richfield, we believe ingenuity is necessary to achieve excellence, and that excellence leads to success. So to increase America's domestic oil reserves, Arco pumps hot water deep beneath Alaska's North Slope, unlocking hard-to-get-at oil. Ingenuity. It's often the unexpected solution that solves those unsolvable problems. Arco, we put our energy into excellence, and this year we're also putting it into the Los Angeles Olympics.
We're back live now. Tim Bright of the United States has already established a new Olympic decathlon pole vault record. And Bright, with a vault of 17.8½, Tim Bright has, you see the cone out there. What happened was he went down the runway to attempt this height, which is 18 feet 1/2 inch. He planted his pole, but he did not cross the plane. But that clock, as you can see, that clock down the runway on the left just kept on running, and then he ran out of time on that attempt. So now they will reset it, and he has one final attempt coming up at this height. So Tim Bright attempting to go up and over the bar. We understand that if he clears the bar here, it will be the greatest height ever attained by a pole vaulter in any decathlon competition. He's already established the Olympic record, Marty.
And I think he's, you know, he's at the end of a long competition. He's tired. He knew that on that last attempt, he just waited and waited. He didn't get the wind, and he's waiting for the right wind behind him. If he had gone and taken that attempt, he would not only be tired, but since there are no other vaulters left in the competition, he would have had to get right back up and go again. So he's trying to pace himself, look for that one big jump.
He's the only man left and has been. All of his buddies have moved on to the javelin area. As we stated before, Jürgen Hinkson has already taken two throws in the javelin, so only Bright remains. He's in the eighth event, and everybody else is into the ninth event in the decathlon. Again, Daley Thompson has built up a very substantial lead at this point overall. As you see the standings after seven, we haven't updated it because Bright is still involved in that eighth event, but Thompson has really increased his lead after seven events. In fact, with 120 more points overall, he now leads by 152 in that head-to-head battle. Vince was third after the seven events. So now Bright again at 18 feet 1/2 inch.
And we saw on that graphic one of the reasons he's taking his time and concentrating so much is that the three Americans are all very close together, and although it does not look like an American is going to get a medal in this event, there's still that competition between the Americans. We may be heading for our worst performance really in the Olympics in the decathlon. The worst our first man has ever done in the history of the Olympics is fourth place, and as you see, we're now down there in I think sixth, seventh, and eighth. So to be the top American and come out of these Olympics with the incentive and maybe the chance of getting some sponsorship as the top American looking forward to the next Olympics, that's the competition that's also down there on the field that the other 90,000 people aren't watching.
18 feet 1/2 inch, and no, Tim Bright missing, and listen to that response from the big crowd at the Coliseum. Keep in mind, too, he was out there for about 4 hours in the pole vault. Pole vault started at about 1:30. So this, by far, in terms of time, the longest event. Some great contrast in the decathlon. That 100-meter dash takes 11 seconds or so for these guys, and then the pole vault takes 4 hours.
Well, the pole vault is one of the longest events in any track meet, and then to put it into a decathlon, it is a problem, because in the final of the pole vault, we only had 12 men in the open pole vault, but here in the decathlon, you've got many more than that.
All right, right now, let's go back to Jack Whitaker.
Thank you, Al Michaels. We have a closer competition here, perhaps. We have in first place now Chen Chaoxia, who's taken over from her countrywoman, Zhou Zhihan. Mitchell of the United States is third. Badeau and the other Australian woman are falling down. And Weiland is in sixth place. We're looking now at the leader. This is the last dive in the preliminaries. This is Chen Chaoxia.
With a back 2 1/2 somersaults pike, she has really been impressing me with her finesse.
Splashy, wasn't it?
Yeah, she had trouble getting her hands back together, and it sounded like the water went right off her head on the finish, as if she missed her hands altogether when going to grab them. Let's see if we can see it. This replay here shows her coming out at the right time, looking back for the water. Let's see what her hands do. They come apart right as she hits the water. It's difficult to see, but that's what happened.
And gets very low marks, 43.50 for Chen. And now let's go back to Al Michaels.
Jack, right now we've got the final throw coming up from Jürgen Hinkson. We saw before his elbow was bothering him, 198.3 on his second throw. And his final throw right here is out around that same area. As a matter of fact, it's actually shy of it because that line represents 197 feet. Thus, Hinkson, with 198 feet 3 inches, only picks up 767 points. In the javelin, Daley Thompson has yet to throw. The reason Hinkson got started earlier was that he was out of the pole vault earlier, so they started some of the decathletes in the javelin. But since Thompson was among those at the end in the pole vault competition, he has not yet begun to throw the javelin. So there is Hinkson in trouble right now. Jürgen Hinkson, world record holder in the decathlon from West Germany. Let's meet him up close and personal.